Hello, and welcome to the Getting Started tutorial for Earth Studio. I'm John, and I'm going to be taking you through just a basic overview of the tool, how to find your way around, make your first animation, and render your project. So let's get started. When you first get to Earth Studio, you'll have the option to either make a blank project or open an existing one. There's more options under these menus, but we're going to ignore those for now and just create a new blank project. We'll give our project a name, in this case, Getting Started, and we'll have options to adjust our dimensions, duration, and frame rate. We're going to leave those all the same right now and just hit Start. And this is Earth Studio. You'll see that the interface is split into three main areas. We have the viewport in the center. This is our main way of controlling the globe, and also a live preview of our final animation. Below the viewport, we have our editor. The editor is split into two parts, the attribute list on the left and the timeline on the right. The attribute list contains a list of every element that can be animated on the globe. By default, you'll see that we have the camera position and camera rotation attributes visible. You'll see their name, their current value, and a keyframe button. The timeline has the frames of our animation all laid out on top and a playhead to mark our current active frame. Finally, we have the top bar. This contains our playback controls, search, and options to save a snapshot of our current view or render our animation. So to get started, I'm going to position the globe to where I want it to be on my first frame. Now I can quick jump to a location by using the search bar right here, and I'm going to search for Tokyo, Japan. You'll see my view is updated. And I chose Tokyo because it has really nice 3D imagery. So now let's frame our first shot. We can move the Earth around by clicking and dragging, right-click and drag up and down to zoom in and out, or use the scroll wheel on your mouse. If you hold the Alt button while dragging, it will orbit your camera around the center of your view. So let's use these controls to frame our shot just the way we want. And I'm trying to get a nice flyover of this area of Tokyo. So to start, I think I'll frame my shot right like this. And when I'm satisfied with how everything looks, I will come down here and click the keyframe all button. And what that will do is it'll save all of the values of my attributes here to the current frame. Now that these keyframes are set, if I move the camera around, you'll see that the keyframe turns yellow. And what this means is that my current view does not match the value of the current keyframe. If I move the playhead off the keyframe, it'll reset and snap back to the saved location. So keeping that in mind, let's make our second keyframe to make our animation. We can drag our playhead to the last frame, and now we can reposition our camera. And I'll do something like this. And here you'll see that all of these keyframes are yellow, meaning that I haven't saved these values to a keyframe yet. So I will click the keyframe all button again to save those values. And just like that, if I press Command and the left arrow key to jump to the first frame and press spacebar, I can preview my very first animation, which is a beautiful flyover of Tokyo. So if I want to make changes to this, there's a few things I can do. I could jump to the last frame here and drag around the globe like we just did earlier, but I don't want to do that, so let's reset. I can also come here and let's say, on this first frame, my altitude is 986 meters. Let's say I'm looking for a more helicopter-style shot where the altitude doesn't change. So I can come over here, look at this altitude, and I can click and drag left and right to scrub it and change its value down. And what this will do will actually change the value of the keyframe without me needing to press the keyframe button again. So I can do that, and then I will move my view to compensate for the changes so my shot is still framed correctly. I'll keyframe those changes again. And I'll play back again. And this is more like it. This definitely has that kind of sped up helicopter flyover feel. So I'm pretty happy with this, and I think it's time to render it out so I can view it outside of Earth Studio. To do that, I'll go up to the render button right here. And now we're at our render settings page. You can see we can change our file name. By default, it's set to the same as our project. We have some basic settings here. We also have the number of frames that we can render. So if, for instance, we only want to render the first 180 frames, we could do that here. And we will see that our preview to the left will update. This is a great way to check that your crop is correct and that the right number of frames are being rendered in the final. We'll switch that back to all frames. We can resize our animation. And then we have our attribution. So Earth Studio Imagery must include attribution to both Google and Google's data providers. By default, we include that as a watermark in the bottom right corner of the screen. You can change the location of that watermark using the menu right here. Just be sure that your usage follows the official attribution guidelines, which I'll post in the YouTube video right here. So when everything's all set, we can hit start. And Earth Studio will go on and step through each frame of our render. The first one will take the longest as it's rendering all of the 3D for the first time. And it saves these images to our local file system in the browser. So this means that if you were to quit out of Chrome, your render would be paused until you revisited Earth Studio again, and then you would have an option to recover. It also means that if you were to have another tab open, the render would pause because there might be some issues when the Earth Studio renderer is not the main focus of your Chrome window. So basically, this will go through and render all the frames. It doesn't take too long, depending on the length of your file. So we will come back and have a fully rendered project. All right, and here's the final product. After the render was done, it downloaded as a zip file to my downloads directory, and I just ran it through After Effects to turn it from an image sequence into a film, and that's what you're seeing right here. So that's it for this getting started tutorial for Earth Studio. We've barely scratched the surface of what's possible in the program, so look forward to tutorials in the future covering things like easing, camera target, multi-view, and lots more. And be sure to check out our documentation in the meanwhile. So, until next time, bye.